What is attraction? Who can I be attracted to? What does it all mean? In this mini audio essay, Shivangi Agarwal, a queer and disability activist and artist, talks to us about what attraction feels like to them and how exploring attraction helped them learn more about gender and sexuality.
Attraction is often described as a feeling of butterflies in the stomach. I can relate to that because when I like someone, I have a giddy feeling all over my body. I smile at the silliest reminders of my crush, and I can't get myself to stop thinking about them. Some of the first conversations that I had with folks with disabilities was about who our crushes were or the celebrities that we found attractive. We would spend a lot of time thinking and researching facts about our crushes and those we feel attracted to. We would make plans on how to express our feelings and what the relationship would look like. As teenagers and young people, we hear about these conversations all around us. It is in all the popular films, music, and TV shows that we consume and enjoy. We often attach our feelings in real life to the characters we see in TV and films, and we love fantasizing about it. I remember that I would spend hours analyzing every detail about my favorite singer and deciding on the qualities about a person that I liked or disliked. Attraction is a special feeling that is individual to us, and it is a feeling that helps us build meaningful relationships. As I am growing up, I am realizing that the conversations that I had with other folks with disabilities about our crushes and our confusions were powerful. I still continue to have those conversations with disabled people of all ages, genders, and sexualities from around the world. These channels of communication with friends and acquaintances have been the root of my discovery and affirmation. That is how I have deeply connected with people. Resolve some of the chaos in my mind, and also how I evaluate what attraction means to me. Instead of what I was told about attraction from general messaging in the media or from the society. We can feel attraction to any gender, sex, or even just for ourselves. There is no such thing as normal when it comes to liking someone. This is something that social media has helped me a lot with. Finding actual people around us who are from different genders, sexualities, disabilities, and castes is the essence of getting to know ourselves and expressing who we are in authentic ways. One of my favorite ways to express my attraction is through writing about it, whether it is in my journal, a text to my friend, or a letter to that person I like. When I first learned about queerness, I wasn't surprised because I always knew that people express love in unique ways. As our body grows and changes, our sexuality and gender transforms as well. When I was younger, I didn't understand my disability or my queerness, and I had a lot of difficulty communicating my problems. Middle school was a time in my life when I refused to acknowledge that I was a queer kid with disabilities. And it was also the time when I had my first crush. I remember that I felt rejected, even though I hadn't actually been rejected or even acted on my feelings. I felt that maybe a body and mind like mine wasn't meant to feel loved and appreciated. And that was primarily because I never saw bodies and minds like mine in those popular media sources. I struggled a lot throughout high school. Those were probably the most difficult years of my life. At that time, I was so focused on just trying to fit in and get good grades that whenever I encountered anything related to love, attraction and sex, I felt that I could never have a life like that. I started identifying a lot with the asexual and demisexual communities because I honestly never felt like I had those feelings. After I graduated high school, I got admitted into a small university in the US. I thought that getting away from the city would help me feel different. We didn't have much money, and my family had to get an education loan and put our house on mortgage. So I felt a lot of pressure to do well when I finally reached Oregon. My main focus was to become a better version of myself and do the best I could. But pretty soon, I started realizing how alone I felt there without the support systems I grew up with, and that kind of loneliness in a foreign country helped me understand myself and my responsibilities better. I started learning how to cook, do laundry, do shopping for necessities, and ride the public transport. I put my focus on these daily chores and finishing each task. I went to random student meetings and events. I said yes to every single opportunity. I got a job in the university library and started living independently instead of the dorms, and within my third month of moving, I even got a full scholarship that helped in putting my parents out of debt. I pulled myself up and went for counseling. I used to feel that writing was the only thing I knew how to do well, having spent all my teenage life journaling efficiently. I started believing in myself, that I had something in me to keep surviving and thriving in my disabled and queer body. This is when I finally felt that I had the agency to feel attraction, love, friendship, and I started dating. I dated tons of people. It came very naturally to me. I realized that I was actually pansexual. It was an amazing feeling. Like I was home in my own body, and that journey took me almost 22 years. When I first fell in love, it was this beautiful girl that I had a crush on for a long time, but I couldn't express it or act on it until I felt mentally strong. Every moment with her felt like magic. I think that's what real attraction feels like, magic. When I feel attraction to someone, I feel confident in my own self and body. I feel like telling everyone I know about that person. Justin Bieber sings, "My first love broke my heart for the first time." And so, of course, that happened to me as well. It was hard to get out of that feeling of heartbreak. But soon, I started dating again. And then I met my current partner, Zaddy, who is non-binary and neurodivergent. It feels like we have the most beautiful and amazing relationship because we understand each other so well. We understand each other's bodies and minds. And now I feel like that is what attraction is, because I feel attracted to Zaddy in new ways every single day as we grow together. Queerness is not always easy to understand. My family doesn't accept my relationship because society only understands relationships that can be legitimized, like marriages or having children. It takes a lot of time and effort to get to know someone, and sometimes things can go wrong or people misunderstand our feelings. It is okay to make mistakes. Another important thing that we need to remember is that it is not the end of the world if someone does not like you back or does not feel the same way. It can be very upsetting to put a lot of energy into one person and not receive it back. Unfortunately, unrequited love is very common. It is important at that point to take time out for yourself and keep fighting for your place in the world of love, romance, and relationships. We are all worthy, as disabled and neurodivergent folks, to be admired, and building those relationships in our own ways is an essential part of growing up. Attraction, friendship, sexuality, and relationships are a process and a practice. They take time and work. I am in my late 20s now, and after a lot of rejection, heartbreak, mistrust, and misunderstanding, I can finally be confident that I have found my chosen family, which involves my partner, a couple of good friends, and my pets. A chosen family looks different for everyone, and therefore, I have a lot of hope and affection for young disabled and queer folks trying to find their place in the world through exploring their feelings that are totally unique to you. And I want you all to know that you are not alone. At this point in my life, I am also realizing that gender is one of those things that changes as well. The more I learn about disability, justice, and queer politics, I feel that I am shedding and dismantling my gender and the ideas I always had about gender. I am connecting more with trans and disabled people on a newer level. Now, whenever I interact with a new young friend with disabilities, I hope that they will also thrive in their experiences, understanding and knowledge of sexuality, gender, love, relationships, and the things that started all. Attraction.
This video ends with two logos on a yellow background. The first one is a pink heart and a plus sign and has PR plus written underneath. And the second one is a green and black eye and has point of view written next to it.